In this video, I'll talk about Bohr's model of the hydrogen atom and then use it to find the wavelength of a photon emitted during a transition from the initial state of 4 to the final state of 2 in the hydrogen atom. So Bohr's model of the hydrogen atom, this is a good analogy for what's going on. He says that electrons can reside in certain orbital states, n equals 1 or n equals 2 or n equals 3, and the electrons then require some energy to change states, to jump, if you will, from one orbital to another. They don't reside anywhere in between, but they can just be in certain orbitals. And you can think of it as a distance from the nucleus. Now, if they require some energy to jump from one orbit, from one distance to another, then it makes sense that if they are going the other direction, let's say it's out in this orbital, n equals 3 orbital, and it jumps down to the n equals 2 orbital, it's going to give off some energy. It is going to give off some energy, and usually it will give off the energy in the form of a photon. So this photon goes shooting off, and it has some energy associated with it. Okay, and depending on the wavelength of the photon, that determines whether it's going to be an ultraviolet, something we can't see, or something in the visible spectrum. So let's see what happens if a photon, or if an electron, changes state from n equals 4 to n equals 2. So the formula that we use is the change in energy of the electron, or of the atom as a whole, you could say. This change in energy equals the Rydberg constant for hydrogen, for the hydrogen atom, multiplied by 1 over the initial state squared minus 1 over the final state squared. So if we plug in what we know, now R sub H is the Rydberg constant, and I'll write that in here. So that change in energy equals 2.18 times 10 to the negative 18th joules. That's the Rydberg constant. I'll write that down for you. R-Y-D-B-E-R-G, the Rydberg constant. And that's just for hydrogen. Well, it's different for different gas atoms. Now, the initial state was 4, the orbital 4, so 1 over 4 squared minus 1 over the final state 2, 1 over 2 squared. So simplifying all of that, you get a change of energy. Now remember, this is for the electron, change in energy equal to negative 4.09 times 10 to the negative 19th joules. Now, this is the beginning of our problem. We needed to find that, and notice that that is energy lost by the electron. And energy lost by the electron is given off in the form of the energy in the photon. So, lost by the electron, and then it is given off as a photon. So the energy of the photon now, the energy of the photon that goes flying away equals H times nu, where H is Planck's constant and nu is the frequency of the light of the photon. So the energy that we have, this 409, now it's going to be positive. The 4.09 times 10 to the negative 19th, this will be positive because it's energy that the photon has, which is now positive. So we have 4.09 times 10 to the 19th equals H times, now nu is now what we want to find. We don't want to find the frequency, we want to find the wavelength is what it's asking for. What is the wavelength? So we use this. Let's just put this in a box over here. We've got nu equals the speed of light over the wavelength. Lambda is used to represent the wavelength. So instead of nu, I'm going to write C over lambda. Okay, C over lambda. Okay, so this energy equals Planck's constant times the speed of light over lambda, the wavelength. So let's write all this down and then solve for lambda. We have 4.09 times 10 to the 19th, the negative 19th, equals Planck's constant, which is 6.63 times 10 to the negative 34th joule seconds. And I was getting a little sloppy here. I should put joules here. Multiplied by the speed of light, which is 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. And then this is all divided by lambda. So solving for lambda, a little bit of space over here, lambda equals 4.87 times 10 to the negative 7th meters. Now we can convert that to nanometers, because oftentimes wavelength is expressed in nanometers. So then the wavelength, and I'm using this blue for, it's no coincidence, 487 nanometers. Turns out that light of that wavelength just happens to look very, very close to this color. So I did that on purpose, just for a little fun, I suppose. We're having fun now, and I hope you did have fun. And if you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.